G'day, I'm Tim Lee, and this is land-based sports fishing on Dirk, Hartog Island. Dirk, Hartog Island is located just off the west coast of WA, and it's an absolute heaven for land-based sports fishermen. In June 2015, myself and four mates went over for a fish, and this is what unfolded.
Predictions for the trip? You think it's going to happen?
I've got a prediction. Tim Lee.
Yeah.
He's going to get a black marlin.
Black marlin. That's a big call.
Baloney. On spinning baloney.
Well, I'm going to get one on spin just to fuck you over.
Be happy. Be happy, Tim Lee.
Alright, yeah. Just
put your beer on your head.
No, I can't. But in closing, is that your best trick, or have you got another one for us?
Watch this trick. It's all about getting away with the boys too.
Yeah.
That's what it comes down to, really.
Well, that's all we appreciate.
I have a couple of goals in terms of species I want to tick off my list. But it's getting away with the boys. Dirk Hartog, 2015. We're gonna do it.
Good fish, guy. Yeah, too
right. It's a holiday too, mate, so, you know.
Exactly right.
It's fun, but you fish hard, so, you know, mate, let's just get there and catch some fish.
Sort it out, hopefully no gearbox troubles.
Well, gearbox haven't gone right there, but you.
I just want to quickly reflect on your fishing past. Marlin, Beecroft.
Yep.
Give me, can you summarise it in 15 seconds?
Marlin, Beecroft, 130, 29, an hour and a half.
You can't do better than that.
Really looking forward to plastic fishing.
Yeah.
We've got a lot more fish over here than we do on the East Coast.
There's a lot of good plastic fishing over here.
Yeah. Looking forward to seeing you guys do the gas ballooning. Really.
You haven't experienced that yet. Is there anything you want to see with the gas ballooning? Like a good few Polarises and
love
strikes?
Love to see the baris come out of the water and hit that bait up in the air.
Get him, prisoner.
Yeah, man.
Come on.
Guys, they get their PBs. Everyone wants their 20 kilo spaniard on speed. I think we can get that for everyone. Ballooning action is going to be insane. The weather's going to be perfect. I'm just hoping for all this. Hope I'm not just going to jinx it all by saying all this. But I think we can get there and have a great trip.
Turn behind the wheel, Hat.
Did we all do our interviews last night?
Yeah. I don't think I interview very well.
It's not the interview, it's just how you look.
Before any big trip to either Steep Point or Dirk Hartog Island, it usually pays to stay at least one night in Denham, just to get last minute supplies and make sure you got everything in order. It's just as well we did on this occasion, because we got 40 cars out of town and my car decided to blow a gearbox.
It's Tobes in front.
Come here, boys.
What's that there? A rope attached to Toby's car.
And it's attached to Tim Lee's car. Tim Lee's.
He's avoiding me at the moment. Doesn't want to talk. Come and speak your mind, Tim Lee.
My fucking clutch gearbox is fucking giving out. Copy that, James.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, we're going to go into the this mechanic in the same spot as we dropped off Leroy's car.
Okay, cool.
There's an orange building of some description or orange sign or something. Denham Coast bloody automotive or something crap like that.
Same street?
Yep.
Thankfully, we weren't too far from town. So all we had to do was transfer gear over to the other car, jump in and keep on going. From Dedham, you travel for about 2.5 hours until you get to Steep Point, where you catch your bars transfer over to the island. The roads are pretty rough and corrugated, but it's still my favourite stretch of road. Once you're around that corner, have a look at the water and Dirk Hartog Island just across the way, it makes the entire trip completely worthwhile.
Morning, Leroy.
Morning.
What's the situation this morning, mate?
Just hanging out for this bloody barge again.
Yeah, right, eh? There seems to be a boat afloat with no one on it behind you.
Not my problem. Barges, that's not.
Our mate's about to come down and claim his boat. It's gone adrift. Put a call out on the radio. We probably could have casted this boat and brought it in, but we don't want to wreck our gear, of course. Here comes the boat rescue team.
Just saying.
What's he gonna do? Get his Spango gear out and fucking hook it?
Water's nice and cold.
Yeah, you...
Water's get... nice and cold.
Get your budgie smugglers on, mate. Go for a swim. He's going for it too. That's got to be cold, boys.
That's got to be cold. Mate, if I was him, I'd run further down.
His nutsack's just come up into his throat, I bet it.
Lucky that didn't happen 4 hours ago.
Yeah, we had a fish about 25 minutes ago.
Yeah, we've been watching it for about half an hour ago. What are these blokes doing?
Yeah, we had the 10 meter meter, too. Yeah, and then saw one last night.
These are the calm waters of Shelter Bay that separates Dirk Hartog Island from the mainland. The barge transfer only takes about 15 minutes and it's great to get over to the other side, because once you look back at the mainland you realise you're in a real remote location. And obviously the fishing is just going to be top class. Once you get on the island, the roads are still corrugated, They're boggy. It's hard going to get to the top of the island where we want to fish. It takes about 3 hours. Despite the hard slog, it's all worthwhile when you get to your designated camp and you realise you've got that deep blue water all to yourself. We're staying in a shack on the island called the Block. As far as rough and ready accommodation on the island goes, this one is absolutely 5-star. And that's why it's also been called the Hartog Hilton.
What are you targeting, mate?
I'm just emptying shit out into this pack so I can take the pack down to the lid.
That's the go.
We're staying on the island for 2 weeks and we want to fish hard, so we bring a lot of gear with us. There's no tackle store around, you can't get supplies nowhere else, so you've got to bring absolutely everything with you. There's absolutely no excuse for not having enough gear.
Chrome.
And let's see what happens on our first morning fishing as we kickstart the trip with a hot snapper bite.
Boys are hooked up on snapper on plastic.
Oh, good reds, man. I forgot to turn the GoPro on.
Oh, that's a good fish.
Oh, that's a dangerous spot
there, son. Alright.
Bring him over here.
No,
mate. Come on,
get down.
Yeah, look
pretty red. You might see
that.
Yeah, it's a good snapper.
Oh,
cod, man. Cod's there. Cod's right there.
Come on, Dirk. We've got big reds coming up.
That cod, watch that cod. Get him, prisoner.
Yeah, mate.
Another one. Another one here. Oh, I've got him.
Yeah, little one, right on the flag.
The demersal fishing on Dirk Artagon is absolutely second to none. Only problem is, every year, there's a big old cod that wants to come along and try and take our snapper.
Yeah, get him, cod's there, cod's there.
Cod wants in. One guy actually got taken. Yep.
Yep.
Fuck, cod's right there. Cheers, bro.
Pull this one up.
What's that snapper? Does it slip down there?
GoPro on, eh?
There's no denying that Dirk Artagon is home to some quality snapper fishing. But that cod, just look at the marks he made down the side of our snapper. Totally ruined our dinner.
Hey, Hacky.
Yeah.
What's going on so far, mate? Tell us.
Plenty of bottom species. Floating activity a little bit quiet.
We just saw a sailie come out of the water.
Just seen a sailie, out wide, plenty of current. No sign of our prized barries so far.
But a few good snapper on the plastics.
Oh, some good snapper on plastics.
The rookie on the plastic.
Flag.
Charlie.
Charlie caught a flat or.
Pretty small snapper of the
day. Nah, not a red. Charlie caught cod or flag or Rankin maybe. Oh, something's got hold of it. Oh, the huge cooter just picked him up.
Cooter just picked him up.
Fucking look at that cooter, mate.
He's got it!
Now, oh!
Come over it again, he's not finished.
Let him eat it. Let him eat it.
Get him out. Got him now. Yeah, you got him now. Tuna on plastic! Gotta gas that bar. That's my hell of a pike.
Time is on.
Hurry up. Can't think of the sun, where is he?
He's over there outside, mate. Come back towards you, heck. That's a horse. He's got a Spaniard.
As big as a Bari.
Sorry, Tobes.
Okay, oh, you got a Bari. Coming.
Shark underneath us, just there.
20 kilo, man.
Yeah. Shark just rocked up.
Gotta get a photo of this, eh?
Yeah. Nice work, Tobes.
Every year we run into some big barracuda, but I've never seen one this big, let alone caught one. Just check out the head on this big fella.
Cooter on plastic. Bring him up for a photo, mate. How do you feel about that, babe?
It's pretty good.
Your poor flag got monstered. Cruiser are down on the low ledge. This is the second time I've heard some choice words come out of Roy since he's been down there.
He's throwing into that hole with the heavy gear and getting absolutely towed. And Hacky's just moved under the 80 pound gear because he just got railed by a GT that was hanging out underneath a turtle, of all things. And stay tuned.
You ask anyone why they really want to come and fish Dirk Hartog Island, and this will be it. Whether it's twitching stick baits, throwing poppers, or ripping high-speed chrome lures through the water, my favourite form of fishing on the island is certainly spinning for pelagics.
Tuna, mate. Nah.
Yeah, bluefin.
Foul hook, sharky or furry, mate.
Not sharky.
Foul hooked.
What?
Furry. It's coming. No, it's. Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, a little bar foul hook, isn't it? Hooked in the mouth for me. Fucking hell, it's got some balls. Hooked in the head. Scalped
him. That's why he's going so fucking hard. There we go. He went a bit hard. He's not bad.
Rubbish, bro.
If targeting Spaniards off the rocks, the most effective method is using high-speed chrome lures. Cast them out as far as you can, let them sink all the way to the bottom, and then rip them back lightning speed. Every strike is just awesome. Check this out.
Leroy just did a dance and he's hooked up to a big barry.
He's telling me to go big bar, do the dance. Big barry.
Yeah, no, keep winching, mate, keep winching. He's alright. Good fish, Leroy.
I'm all fucking morning for that. Come on, sweat.
Yeah, bro, you can need an extra hand.
I'm think I've done it.
Haki's on a big bar. Yeah, good fish. Watch, he doesn't get out of that rock, Hack.
Down with the gas.
At least 12. After all I knew it had to be something to do with you. I really don't mind what happens now and then, as long as you'll be.
Big bar, boys. Oh, that's a good bar. Out there, it's a good bar.
Chuck on it. He's turned off. Took for granted all the times I never let you down. You stumbled in and bumped your head. If not for me, then you'd be dead. I picked you up, put you back on solid ground. Now this is what we don't want to see. There's two sharks chasing Hack Spaniard. They're the demise of every single land-based sports fisherman in WA. A lot of good fish would have been landed on this trip if it wasn't for these guys. But you just got to do what you can and make the most of every hookup.
He's got the tail. Here's a good bar.
Yeah, now, anyways. Hello, Dirk.
Traveling in a fighter combi on a hippie trailhead full of zombies. I met a strange lady. She made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under? Where women go and men blunder. Can't you hear the thunder? You better run, you better take cover.
He's just about to drag off. Let it run wide, just in case there's any sharks after it. Hopefully that Spaniard can just outrun the sharks and
by the time he comes back in, he's a lot more relaxed and doesn't fuss too much, so the sharks don't really want to have a guard him too much. Great head shakes in it. Just giving him some stick. Toby's done this a million times before, so he's pretty good at what he does when it comes to this sort of stuff. Got Packy on the gaff. Oh, good barry. Good Spaniard. Go, Hacky. It's a Spaniard. Well done, Tobes. That's well played, bro.
Nice one.
Yeah. Put one on the rocks.
For once.
Grab a photo.
Yeah.
Oh, he spat a little.
Perfect.
Giving out garfish baits under the propulsion of helium gas is very visual fishing. It's real exciting. A lot of the time, the Spaniards will come up and spear clean out of the water to get that bait. On this occasion though, the big Spaniard just comes up, sips it straight off the surface. After taking the bait, this fish just ran straight back towards us. We weren't even sure if he was hooked up or not, but it didn't take long for the weight to come on the rod. Leroy wound up tight and struck hard.
Go, 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 go. Yeah, boy.
Well done, bro.
Yeah, good Mackie. No strings attached. Can I get up? Yeah, he's up on surface. Oh, he's scooting, boy.
Who fucking in that? Who fucking in that? Not playing, keep it moving.
Here come the gap. I don't think he's on anymore, bro. You just got balloon weight there now. Yeah.
Balloon line down. And that's because Roy's on the rod. Oh, sorry, bro. Gonna play gaff man prisoner? Just over there near the other rod, bro.
I'm on it.
You're on it? Look out, he's here to gaff, everyone. How's it feel, Roy? Code. If that line goes around that rock, cruise them, make sure you fucking push it around, mate, with the gaff.
Like now.
Like now.
You listening?
Push that line out away from the rocks.
That's out.
It's down here, Bruce. Cobe. Cobe.
Fuck, what's a cobe come up from there, Lord?
Cobe. Cobe, you're down here. Quick. Good cobe. Come on, Mr. Cobe.
You like that one? We come off.
Go again.
Go again.
Right, Roy?
Yeah.
Oh no.
We're cut up a piece of the gaff.
Untangle it.
Go now. Go, you got him.
Yeah, boy. Good cove. That's a cracking cove, mate. That's a cracking cove.
What's the hardware, man? With your legs.
Fucking what I missed earlier on that lure, didn't you?
Yeah, that was a big fish.
Oh, yeah, cove, right. Man. Possibly.
It was, definitely.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's what I fucking hooked.
Maybe.
Maybe.
On the Mac Bay.
Maybe.
That's a good cove, bro.
Sweet.
Good card, boy.
Thanks, mate.
Should have been my fish, but that's all right. It's acceptable. If yours was a cove, that was a big cove.
Big cove. Thanks, Rocky.
Way of gaffing I've ever done. No, we weren't going to say anything about that.
Cove's an absolute freak again.
Just kept rolling.
Good cove, man. First big bar.
Yes, they do. Laughed
at me.
Typically do.
My swivel popped.
And now we're all after it.
Yeah. Now I have to clean out Leroy's car.
I have to say, I wanted to say it was a full rookie maneuver, eh? It was a rookie maneuver to lock up that drag. Try to go one on one with the Holy Grail.
I was there, man. It wasn't too bad. Wasn't too bad.
One of those.
What do you reckon, Leroy?
Mate, you don't lock down on them. You can't, especially when you're a rookie.
So, how many of you boys have hooked 20 kilo blurries this trip?
Yeah, this trip, well...
Just out of curiosity.
Makes me wonder whether yours is 20. Because you haven't even hooked one 10 yet, have you?
No, he hooked the 20.
Oh,
he
hooked
it out
the other day.
Yeah.
This one was bigger.
He has possibly hooked the two biggest barriers of the trip. The only two he's helped.
That's that little one.
That's a rookie.
I've got that little one.
Liv, come on. It was a bit bigger than that.
Pretty boring video, but... little bolognese.
Little, they don't get that big down. I don't think they're born bigger than that.
Probably are. They come out just teeth.
I'll be skipping it on Sunday if you got one that size.
Good one.
photo for you.
Yeah, we'll get a photo.
Beauty.
I'm gonna pass Saki to Gaff. Where is that?
We haven't got the good camera on us on this occasion, so we're going to have to make do with the GoPro footage. This time, it's my turn to get stuck into a few nice Spaniards.
Nice one. Landed a 20. Then he landed another 20. Despair. Total despair.
Are on the balloon.
Gap. Yeah, just in case he rubs you on that left hand side, I'd go left a bit, mate.
Leroy's down there with the gap.
Keep going down, prisoner. He's a lot closer than what you think, mate.
Balloon's just there, which puts the fish about here into the gaff man right there.
Ish.
Silver.
Yeah, see silver. That's a good mac.
Oh, it's a good bar.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
well done, Roy.
Oh,
that's a good bar. Is it balloon? The weather has turned from good. It's pretty crap. And if you look over there, he's the cleanest man in landbased game. Chris Hack. That's where we go fishing.
Chris! Got anything in there?
Chris is trying to find God, I think, or rocks. Because his tent's down there. And it's coughing it. That's dark as fuck. Ah, he's got a big old rock.
About to get Dirk Hartog.
say rookie down there that already has been there. $19.95 available from your local Kmart. And that's where you land up. Bed Bug City. Nice dry sleep over there. 2L, champion of rice.
And rice legs.
Hobes, he's done alright. He's put himself in the back of that. What's going on with this thing? There he goes in the back there. Oh, I feel some sprinkles.
Oh, that's going to bad. Holy shit!
We are going to be Dirk.
He's
going
to get Dirk.
Get out of there! Oi! Chris! Evacuate!
Oh, yeah. There's the front there.
It's sailing Sunday. We're waiting for a bit of south in the wind. It's blowing us ass off, man. Prisoner's tent. Cost $5 more than Hacks. And it's still standing.
We caught a ton of fish on this trip, way more than what we got on camera. So with the freezer full, we certainly let a fair few go. Here's a few clips to show, a little bit of catch and release. This is a great look at the low ledge at the block. In good conditions, it makes for the best lure fishing platform. You can get right down the water level and spin to your heart's content. It's absolutely fantastic.
Wake it up now.
We Come on, Hacky.
Yeah, should be able to.
Can you get him up there or you want to pull him up?
It's not bad.
Good for a release, he's just got their travel in him.
Your employer's Prosner?
Yeah, have a little pocket, eh? Have you got flies down there, Tony? Yeah.
Release job?
Yeah, it's only just on the treble.
Good fish.
Perfect,
just
on the fucking treble.
Beautiful.
Spear it in, Chris. Head first. Torpedo him.
Beautiful. And then a big brown shark came. Just sulking on that corner. And that is a thing of beauty. Seeking fortune and glory, it's a short song, but it's a hell of a story when you spend your lifetime trying to get your hands on the Holy Grail. But have you heard about the Great Crusade? We ran into millions and nobody got paid. Yeah, we raised four corners of the globe for the whole.